feet. The simple level is our mayor and our colleagues, Janice Sarich, David Child, Aaron Lewis, Thomas Lukasik, Steve Young, and others that I can't spot quickly enough. And to our UCC Edmonton branch, that he, and of course, Mr. Zelitsky, our keynote speaker, and with some particular thanks to our St. George's Choir for their very beautiful singing on the headline, as well as the two hymns. And perhaps, before I get to the survivors, to our young people who are here today from PLOS, Ukrainian bilingual programs, and just from Ukrainian homes of heart, Ukrainians, thank you very much for being here, and of course to our survivors, of whom this is all and whom it is all dedicated. It gives me great pleasure to be here on behalf of the province of Alberta and all MLAs who serve you in the Legislative Assembly to bring you some brief remarks with respect to one of the greatest tragedies that ever befell mankind. We have heard and we will continue to hear many people speak about this tragedy that unfortunately took the lives of upwards of 10 million innocent men, women, and children. It's a chilling statistic that we would never like to see repeated. However, as I look at Ukraine's situation today, I see a different kind of starvation setting in. It's a starvation of freedom, a starvation of democracy, brought in by the incursion of a very mean-spirited wheel that's in motion. It has gone through Crimea, it's going through eastern Ukraine. Where it will stop, I do not know. But the starvation I speak of is one that's happening during our lifetime. The starvation that we're commemorating today happened in a lifetime for a few in the room, but fortunately some survivors are here to bear witness to it. Let us hope that the modern starvation of democracy is stopped in its tracks. Member of Parliament Lori Hahn just mentioned with leadership such as shown by our Prime Minister and numerous others, not just the European Union, but the rest of the world who are standing up.
Thank you, it's His Worship, Mayor Neville Jacobs. And for the first time, I'd like to welcome you, Mayor, to this event. There's people here at City Hall. We're hoping that you could be here last year, so we could offer you our congratulations on the mayor's seat in Edmonton. Very proud that you are able to join us today, and I promise you that if you do come next year, I'll bring my Ivison Bond sign with me, and so we can take a back your campaign on that. Welcome.
In the early 1930s, millions of children
harder still to imagine that such devastation could be deliberately inflicted in an attempt to systematically destroy the Ukrainian people's aspirations for a free and independent nation. It's an ugly, violent chapter of human history, but it is one that we will never forget. When we forget what people are capable of, or what people are capable of, we can miss the signs of oppression and aggression that allow such atrocities to occur. The speaker was also pointed. And so I take pride as a Canadian that Canada was the first country to recognize the Ukrainian famine as an act of genocide. And prouder still that in 1983, the world's first public monument to the victims of the Holocaust was erected and dedicated right here in Edmonton, right outside our city hall. And some of you in this room will have been instrumental in doing that work to get that monument created. If it were, you raise your hand. Some of you? Some of you. Well, for any of you who had a hand in it, thank you, because it serves as a reminder, as I said, every day for those of us as we go forward, of what happened, and that we must cherish the memory of those who were lost and resolve to ensure that such injustice never occurs again in our world. This monument provides that reminder of that chapter of Ukraine's history, but as well it serves as a monument to freedom and democracy. Ukraine has traveled a very long and very arduous path to achieve its independence. And with recent events, once again, threatening their safety, security, and independence, is a reminder we all need to keep. Our thoughts and prayers are with the people of Ukraine, and of course, with our local Ukrainian community. So you are always welcome at City Hall, but especially on this day, the 4th Saturday of every November, we look forward to welcoming you.